Welcome everyone, I'm Marco Zuppone, I'm a Sentinel trainer based in Cambridge, UK, and in this short video I will talk to you about how to detach an SL network key in brief. First of all, let's see what we intend for detachable license. A detachable license is one that can be borrowed from the license server to a workstation for a specific time, and it is used when the workstation is not able to communicate with the license server. When the borrowing time period expires, the license returns automatically to the concurrency pool, even if the communication between the server and the workstation with the borrowed license is never restored. A typical business case is when a user needs to use a licensed software, but he or she is on the move and unable to connect directly with the licensing server. Let's see it graphically. This represents the license server hosting the SL key with detaching capabilities. The detach operation is performed and a token is installed on the workstation. The number of tokens detached, one in this case, is subtracted from the concurrency pool of the key on the license server. Now, the protected application on the workstation can run even if the communication between the workstation and the license server is interrupted. When the borrowing time expires, the token becomes invalid and the concurrency pool of the license servers is replenished. To be able to detach a license, the detachable functionality must be activated by the ISV when the SL license is issued. The end user that administers the license server can define some parameters about the detaching functionality using the admin control center. These settings can be always overridden by the ISV using the Sentinel admin API. If the detached license is not needed anymore before the expiration of the borrowing time, it's possible to return it earlier to the concurrency pool. And now let's see in practice how the license detaching process works. We are now on my lab. This lab is called LDK Lab minus PC. This computer is a Windows 7 computer where I deployed my network license. It's an SL admin mode network license. If we have a look to the product is called the net test. As you can notice, we have this small arrow there, red arrow, that means that the product is detachable. It shows you some details. It shows that this product is made of the feature 333 and that can be detached for a maximum of 14 days. So we have three licenses available in the pool, three concurrent licenses available. And if we want to drill down, we can click features. And as we can see, we see that the product net test ID21 is made of the feature 333 that is detachable and has a concurrency limit of 3. So now let's move on another computer. This computer has a protected application that will use that license remotely. So if we look in the ACC of this one, we see that there are no local license keys. This ACC is able to see the license hosted from the other computer. So in this computer is called LDK client. The license is in LDK Lab PC, and of course it's the same license that I showed you before in this LDK Lab PC. So let's start to consume this license remotely. And this works perfectly because the client computer and the computer that hosts the license are able to communicate. If I return here and I go to products, I can see that now my pool is only 2 because someone is using this feature. So if I go to feature and I go to sessions, I can see that someone from the LDK client computer is using this feature. So far, so good, nothing special, because the two computers are able to talk each other without problems. Let's close now this application, and let's make the hypothesis that the user of this computer, the client computer, needs to go away from the office, he needs to commute. And so the operator already knows that will not be able to connect to the license server of the computer that is hosting the network license. So what they need to do? They need to detach the license to get a token here that will allow this computer to use the protected application even without direct communication with the licensing server. So let's open the ACC of this machine. Let's go to the products. Now the pool is again 3 because I closed the application, and I click the button detach. There are two ways to do the detaching, online and offline. In this example, we are doing the online mode. The online mode requires that this computer, that actually is the client, is still able to talk with the server. In the case that this computer already left the office without doing the detaching, the administrator of the computer where the license server is installed can use the offline detaching to get a license for this computer, exchanging some files. In this video, I will show you how to do an online detaching. Okay, so we click on online. We can set some expiration date if we want. We can leave it like that for now. And I press this button. The license is successfully detached. If I return back to Sentinel Keys, I have looked to products, I can see now this green arrow here. That means that I have the detached license for this product. So let's try it now. So we go here on this computer, that is the one with the licensing server, and we shut it down. So now we can see that we have this key here with this green arrow. That means that I have detached something. So if I have a look to features, I can see this feature with the expiration date, because the detached license has a duration limit. Okay, so it's the time to run the protected application. The protected application works even if the license server is not available, because I have a detached license. So if I have a look to the ACC again, I can see that I'm consuming this license. This license will expire naturally after the borrowing time expires. So if we have a look, we can see that this license will expire the 2nd of May, that is the limit of my borrowing time. But if we return back to the office before that date, we have the possibility to give this license back to the license pool. Let's have a look. So I'm starting again my license server. I open the ACC. As I can see here, I have still two licenses available, and one is actually detached. So if I click on the detached one, I can see where is detached. So if I go to my computer where the token has been detached, I can do this. I cancel the license, so I return back this token before the natural expiration. If I don't do this operation, this token will expire and the pool will be replenished on the machine that holds the real license. But if I want to give the license back before the time, I can do that. Press it. Say yes. I want to cancel this license. If we have a look to the computer that with the license server, and I go here on Sentinel keys, products, I can see that I have all my licenses back. This brings us at the end of this session. I hope you find it useful and interesting. Please stay tuned to our channel for other videos. Thank you and bye.